Welcome to today's modular classroom. We are going to see about planning in artificial intelligence. So what is planning? Planning in AI is about the decision-making tasks that are performed by the robots or the computer programs to achieve a specific goal. The execution of planning is about nothing to choose a sequence of action. So the sequence of action steps are being carried over with the help of this planning. So nothing but planning is arranging a sequence of actions to achieve a goal. So we'll take the example of the blocks world problem. The block world consists of a structure like this, where a flat surface such as the tabletop and an adequate set of identical blocks which are identified by letters like this A, C, B, so and so. The blocks can be stacked one upon another. A is on C like that, and there is a robot arm that can manipulate the blocks. This is the robot arm, and the robot can hold one block at a time, and only one block can be moved at a time. This robot arm can handle only one block at a time, and at the same time only one block can be in transmit, and any number of blocks can be on the table. See, two blocks can be in this state, and in this state also two blocks is there. This is the example. So the actions that are performed on those blocks world problem are, first action is, you can say it as unstack of A comma B. So what is meant by unstack of A comma B means you are going to remove block A from block B. For that, the robot arm must be empty and block A must have no blocks on top of it. This is the first action. And the second action is stack of A comma B. For that, you are going to put the block A on the block B. For that, the robot arm must already be holding A, so that only it can put A block on B block. Third point is the surface of B must be clear, so that only you can put the A on B. And the third action is pickup of A. For that, the pickup block A from the table. Arm must be empty and there must be nothing on top of A. And the put down of A is fourth action, means you are going to put the block A on the table. The arm is already holding that block A. So these actions, unstack of A comma B, stack of A comma B, pick up of A, put down of A. These four actions to achieve it must in the precondition like this. So these actions, these four actions can be said in the form of predicates like on A comma B means block A is on block B. On tables of A means block A is on the table. Clear of A means there is nothing on top of block A. And holding of A means the robot arm is holding block A. Arm empty means the arm is holding nothing. So as you saw in the previous slides, those actions are being used for performing the operations like stacking, unstacking, clearing, putting, etc. For this, the predicates are being used to represent in this method. The next step is, this way the logical notation can be used like this form. For all of x, holding of x implies negation of arm empty. On table of x implies negation of y on x comma y. These notations are being theoretically said as, if the arm is holding anything, then it is not empty. Then it is not empty means negation of arm empty. So it is holding something. So robot arm is not empty because it is holding something. Holding something in the sense it is holding some block. Second one is, if a block A is on the table, then it is not also on another block. It is on the table means it will not be in the another block. A third option is, any block with no block on it is clear. Clear of X means it does not have any block on surface of it. These are the logical notation used. Next, we're going to see about the components of a planning system. So what are the components of a planning system means? First one is, choose the best rule based upon your heuristic information. Apply this rule to create a new state. Third, detect when a solution has been formed. Fourth, detect dead ends so that they can be avoided. Detect when almost current solution has been formed and employ special techniques to make it totally correct. These are the five components, five steps that are used to form the components of a planning system. We'll see one by one. First one is, choose the best rule upon the heuristic information. So first point is, you have to find the differences between the current state and the goal state. then choose the best rule that reduce these differences. Example suitable for means and analysis. In a real sense, you take that as wishing to travel by the car to visit a friend. For this, to achieve from your place to your friend place by traveling through the car, your first point is you have to fill up the car with a fuel. And if you have no car, means you have to acquire one. So from this 2 points, the largest difference, that is, which is the target of achieving the goal state, must be tackled first. The second point is apply this rule to create a new state. Applying the heuristic information, you have to create a new state. If in simple systems means applying rules is easy, but in complex system means we have to deal with the rules as specified only a small part of the problem state. One way to describe is each action, each of the changes it makes to the state description. There are a variety of approaches have been used for this task. We have to apply a particular state to create a new state. Now, for example, we have applying a method called Green's approach. Green's approach means a given state has been described with a set of predicates representing the facts that were true in that state. Each state was represented explicitly as part of the predicate. So, for example, say take the same simple Bloxwell description. Your state will be like this. That is, on A, B, comma, is not means that A is on B in the first state, and on table B, comma, is means B is on the table in the first state, and clear of A, comma, is means A is of clear. That no block is on the block A. This figure is in the state of SO because a simple block's representation. Now, if you want to do the operation unstack A, comma, B, that operation has been expressed as clear of X, comma, S, and on X, Y, comma, S, it implies and it takes to you to another state Y. To do unstack of A, comma, B, you need two states, two blocks, that is X block and Y block, and S is a particular state. You have to apply a particular function, do function, because that will specify a new state result from the given action. So from applying that rule, from the state S2, S naught to S1, you will go to a state called holding and clear. You will pick up that A block and B block will be clear now. That will be in the state S1. But there also a problem in this state is that B will be still on the table. For that, you have to encode your frame axioms like this. On table is it comma S implies on table is it comma do unstack. You have to include the do function over here. And at the same time, if you want to color these blocks, you can also use another axiom called color of X comma. Your X denotes any color. The STRIPS approach is being another method is the STRIPS approach. First method you saw is a Green's approach. The STRIPS approach, STRIPS has been abbreviated as Stanford Research Institute Planning System. It is nothing but a mechanism that does not require a large number of explicit frame axioms. You need only to apply three lists of predicates with each operator. Each operation is described by a list of new predicates that became true means it is called as add. List of all the predicates that became false means it is called as delete. And list contains those predicates that must be true for the operator to be applied is called as a precondition. So anything not in this list is assumed to be unaffected by the operation. So new predicates, if it has become true, it is called as add. Old predicates, if it become false, it is called as delete. And the predicates which will be true if you apply a particular operator means it is called as a precondition. We'll now see that STRIPS world problem, how the operator apply. So stack of X comma Y means P denotes your precondition, D denotes your delete, and A denotes your add. Precondition means to apply stack of X comma Y, you need the precondition. Y must be clear and X must be in the robot arms. And D means after deletion, after applying that operator, clear of Y and holding of X will be the same. That next one, arm empty, it is add a list liner kuna. Arm empty, that is robot arm will be empty, and at the same time X will be on Y, on operation will be applied. So mostly precondition and delete operation will be similar to all the operations. Unstack, pick up, put down. Similarly, just see P and D will be similarly same. This will be the component.